Hi everyone and welcome to my brand new channel. I'm so excited to tell you what it's all about. So in this first video, I'm gonna do an overview of the whole project. We're gonna talk about animatronics, 3D printing, electronics, printed circuit boards, software. Hop along, welcome to AnimaMaestro. Hi everyone and welcome again to my channel. My name is Gilles, I'm a French-Canadian from Montreal and I'm a software engineer. And as you might have guessed, I'm also passionate about electronics and robotics. So in this channel, I'm gonna talk to you about a project that I started many years ago. It's an animatronic that I called AnimaMaestro. So as you probably know, animatronics are robotic figures that you can program to execute various animations. And in general, they include audio tracks to which the movements of the figures are synchronized. Animatronics were invented in 1963 by Walt Disney himself. So for his Disneyland theme park in California, he created a show with animated birds, flowers, and statues. And these figures were talking, singing, and dancing to a musical soundtrack. So this show was called The Enchanted Tiki Room. Disney called these figures audio-animatronics, not only because the figures were synchronized with audio tracks, but also because the signals that were used to actuate the figures were actually audio signals coming from the audio track as well. So that's why he called them audio animatronics. But nowadays, because the figures are actuated using many different ways, we simply use the general name animatronics. Given the big success that this attraction had in Disneyland, Walt Disney was asked to build some attractions for the New York's World's Fair in 1964. So Disney built four attractions for the fair, and I would like to mention two of them. The first one is called Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln, and it features a really impressive animatronic representing the former US president. And it was really impressive at the time. And this attraction still exists today in Disneyland in California. But over the years, the animatronic has evolved and it has been really, really improved. The second attraction that I want to mention is called Carousel of Progress, and it features a really impressive cast of audio animatronic figures. We see a complete family with father, mother, children, grandparents, and even their dog. And we follow them through four different scenes during the attraction. And this attraction still exists today in Walt Disney World in Florida. Given the huge success that these two attractions had at the New York World's Fair, Disney kept including animatronics in their attractions through the years. The figures represent characters like humans, animals, creatures, robots, any character that can help tell the story, they will use animatronics to animate them. And over the years, these animatronics really, really improved. And today they are really fluid and have a lot of motions and a lot of articulations and are really, really fun to watch. Being a huge theme park fan, I had the opportunity over the years to visit Walt Disney World in Florida, as well as Disneyland in California many times. And through the years, I was able to capture images of most of the animatronics that we see in those theme parks. And these are the images that you see right now. So as you can see, I really love these audio animatronics figures, and for as long as I can remember, I had the dream to build my own. So about 10 years ago, I decided to start building my own project. Now, there are multiple ways to approach such a big project. Nowadays, all the components that are required to build an animatronic figures, power supplies, motor drivers, LED drivers, sensors, microcontrollers, etc., are all readily available. Most of them can be found in pre-packaged modules that you can connect together to achieve your goals. A good example that many of you may know are the Arduino series of hardware components and software libraries that you can pick and choose and assemble together to achieve your needs. But for my project, I wanted to take the opposite approach, and because I'm curious and I'm always eager to learn, I decided that I would build all the components myself. So I wanted to create and design my own electronic circuit boards and assemble them myself as well. I wanted to code my own motor drivers, and I wanted to design and assemble all the mechanical parts. I also wanted to code my own animation application. So I really decided that I would do, you know, almost everything by myself. And that's what I started to do about 10 years ago. So here you can see a first prototype that I did. You can see the first versions of the electronic circuits. You can see the first version of the animation application. You can also see the first prototype of a hand that I did, and of the shoulders and the arm of the animatronic. And as you can see, it is made of balsa wood. So it's a wood that's really, really light, mostly used for RC planes. But in the end, for my project, it turned out to be not strong enough. So with the advent of 3D printing, I decided that I would go towards that technology, and I decided to start modeling my animatronic using a 3D CAD application. So this is how AnimaMaestro, my animatronic project, was born. So in this channel, I want to bring you along my journey. I want to show you how I designed, implemented, tested, improved, and assembled all the components for this project. So I have organized this channel into 7 video series. Each series will focus on a certain class of components that are required for the project, and here they are. The first series of videos that you will find on the channel is called AnimaMaestro Figure. It will focus on the design, fabrication, and assembly of the actual animatronic. So we will take a look at the 3D modeling process, watch actual 3D printings of some of the parts. The series will also showcase the various mechanical components needed for the project, including DC and servo motors of all sizes, nuts and bolts, metal rods, plastic chains, ball bearings of various shapes and sizes, and even some Lego pieces. The AnimaMaestro figure is mounted on a wooden box, which I call the stage box. So the box contains all the electronics and power supplies needed to animate the figure. So because the stage box is such an important component of the project, it will probably become its own video series at some point. Finally, this series, AnimaMaestro Figure, will also include the actual assembly and testing of the animatronic. The second series is the AnimaMaestro Units series, and it will focus on the design and implementation of the units' electronic boards. Each unit includes power management components, an EEPROM to store configuration data, as well as a microcontroller to operate the unit. For all the electronic boards on my project, I use Microchip PIC32MX microcontrollers. The project currently has 3 types of units. The pulse width modulation units can each generate up to 16 PWM signals and are used to drive DC motors, servo motors, as well as RGB LEDs. The AnimaMaestro NeoPixel units can each control 4 NeoPixel strips for a total of nearly 250 NeoPixels at full brightness. Finally, the amplifier units each include 4 stereo 3-watt amplifiers to provide sound and music to the AnimaMaestro figure. The next series of videos is the AnimaMaestro Controller series, and it will feature the design and implementation of the controller's electronic boards. So the project includes a primary and a secondary controller. Each provides power and communication coordination for up to 8 units, for a total of up to 16 units. Each controller is powered by a standard ATX PC power supply, and communication with the 8 units is provided through a complex programmable logic device, or CPLD. So for all my electronic boards, I use Xilinx XC9500 CPLD devices. Each controller also includes temperature monitoring and fan management, as well as handling of the emergency stop button. The fourth series of videos will be dedicated to the AnimaMaestro Conductor. So the AnimaMaestro Conductor is a small computer that connects to the AnimaMaestro primary controller and can manage animation playback autonomously, or can also be connected to a host computer via USB. So the conductor includes an LCD module, a matrix keyboard, a beeper, some LEDs. It also has an SD card capable of storing audio and animation data. It includes two stereo DACs to play back four channels of high quality audio. It also features a real-time clock to allow scheduled animation playback. And finally, the conductor also has an RF module, so it can be operated via a remote control. The next series of videos on this channel will focus on my animation application called AnimaMaestro Composer. The application features a plugin-based architecture that can connect to the AnimaMaestro Conductor via USB. This allows the user to configure the AnimaMaestro units, playback audio and animation data in real time, as well as store animation sequences into the conductor's SD card. The application offers various controls to individually animate each of the figure's actuators with keyframes and interpolation. The Composer application can also play video to help when creating animations. The next series will be dedicated to the AnimaMaestro Remote. This is an RF remote control that I designed to communicate with and operate the AnimaMaestro Conductor. This short series will look at the 3D modeling and 3D printing of the remote control, the design and implementation of the electronic board, which includes a LiPo battery charger, as well as firmware programming of the remote. The final series that you will find on the channel is called Tools and Workshops. The first videos on the series will talk about a tool that I made to test the custom servo motors that I use on my animatronic. So once I install a motor and its sensor on the figure, I can use that tool to test that it works properly, determine its rotation direction, as well as the basic values of its sensor. But ultimately, my goal with this last video series would be to include short videos to explain certain concepts or talk about certain topics. For example, how do servo motors work? What is a Stewart platform? What is a PID controller? How do CPLD work? Perhaps include some microcontroller programming advice or software design guidelines. So any subject really. If you have ideas, if you have subjects that you would want me to talk about, let me know in the comments below. And in the future, I'll try to add these videos. So there we are, 7 video series. And in each of them, I'll try to cover all the aspects of the project. The design of the parts and the circuits, the mechanical and electronic components, the firmware and software design and programming, as well as the assembly and testing of the figure itself. So I hope I've triggered your interest, and I hope that you'll subscribe and turn on the notification bell to be notified when I upload the next videos. Meanwhile, I would be really interested to know about your projects and if you have any questions as well. So write them down in the comments below. And until next time, keep creating. Hi everyone, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button below. And if you want to learn more about my animatronic project, please consider subscribing and also turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of the videos that I upload. Meanwhile, you can take a look at these videos, and until next time, keep creating!